installer valve train. This application, we're using a new Stipe 250 cam, correct? Now we put a 250 in it. The valves from the vendors are a little bit too long when you install the Stipe cam along with adjustable lifters. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm just going to make sure that all my lifters are all the way down, and I'll show you an example. This one I've already done. I've got it down. I'll crank this lifter down to where it's down, and you can see the valve is still above its seat. And so I'm going to go through here and just get all of these back down to where the valve will seat. Just run them down to where they almost are bottomed out. But these valves, we took 100 thou off of them, and that's typically just a real good number to shoot for. That generally works. But I want to get it to where the valve is seated, and it's seated when you can just push on it. You can't spin it. If you can spin it, it isn't seated in. A local machine shop did the valve job for us on this one because we didn't have the tools here to do it. But basically he went in and installed hardened seats in the block for us and then ground the valve to the valve seat. And he even went as far as to already lap them in for us. So that was kind of a nice little treat. But the valve won't spin. And this one's all the way down. That one's down. Okay, so we got play in them, a little clearance. And I want to go through and adjust all the valves right now. I'm just going to hold down on it for pressure against it. And I'm going to set this up according to what Stipe asks in his information, and that's 10 thousandths clearance. No, I wanted to go. Didn't need to run that down in there as far as what I did do. I've got no clearance now. And I'm using a go, no-go gauge, which I like, prefer. Bit too far. That's just a little snug. There it went. Mm. All right, so there's my go-no-go, which is about 11,000ths on this end and 9,000ths on that end. So if it'll slide through without much drag, but not go up into the larger point, it's called good. And I'm putting pressure down on the valve, and I know that the lobe is all the way down, and that's a good fit. Now, when I put the spring on it and the keepers and such, generally this won't change because the springs are only 24 pounds of pressure anyhow, and I'm probably putting that much on it holding it down. But after I get them all installed, I'll go through and check them again, just fine tune it if something needs. So I'm going to do them all that way, and then we'll come back and install the springs. So my gauge drags through it a little bit, and just a little bit more, just a touch. Another thing I'd like to point out, are you on?
Mm-hmm.
Come around here in the front of the motor. We installed our cam and crank, and we highlighted our timing marks. And you want to make sure that you do have that correctly done, so our marks are meeting, so it means our cam is in time with the crankshaft.
Spin that again. Yeah,
okay. That's pretty good. So we've set all of our valves at 10. Your mileage may vary. I know a few people like to run at 10 and 12, 12 on the exhaust, 10 on the intakes. What little bit of information we've gathered off of, I'm not even going to mention the dyno. 10 is what the manufacturer of the cam states is the setup. Some people prefer putting a couple of more thousandths on the exhaust valves and run 10, 12. Some people might like 15. Whoever you buy your cam from or have a cam reground by, generally they'll give you their recommendations. I think on Chaffin's cams, I think he calls out 15, and on his regrinds, 15. You'll get some information with the cam that gives you the valve lash that you should set it up with. And I recommend that you start out there. You can always play with it and see if it does. These are new from the vendor. And there's a small pin that goes through the hole that's in the valve.
Okay.
And these are new pieces. We've put a lot of new pieces in this engine, and it's mainly because we started with a block. So we didn't have an engine tore down, tore apart, or, you know, these keepers are good and they're not worn thin. You could reuse them. If your spring pressures are all about 24 pounds at seat pressure, they're fine. The pins, though, generally when they pull them out, you'll see quite a bit of wear on them, so I would recommend that you replace the pins. But putting the valve together is just a matter of getting the valve. And I got a little oil here somewhere, a little oil on the valve stem. And drop it down in where it's going to go when I do drop it down where I want to get that, I want to make sure that hole's out here where I can access it to put that pin in. And you can use your thumbs. Pretty easy here to do. The keeper goes on the bottom. Just crank your valve out of your lifter out of the way and push that up on it. I'm kind of at the wrong angle to do this one, but let's see if I can't get it. And just push it into place. And then a pair of needle nose pliers are really handy. Okay, after you get it placed kind of where it goes, again, I want to install that to where I can access that hole and put this small pin in. Oh, and I might make a comment here. Oversized valves, if you're reusing your old keepers, a lot of times you got to come in here and drill that out to where it fits. These are 15 over valves. They fit. If we had 60 over valves, we'd have to open that hole up to make that work. So there's my hole. I'm going to stick it down in there where I can access it. And with a pair of needle nose, I'm going to wiggle and jiggle that around to where it went into place. In other words, it dropped down in through the keeper. And we have what I think is probably a vendor supplied ring compressor. And it's just in, so I'll compress up the spring and I'm going to put my pin in there and just reach around the back side, center it up and drop it in place. So we now have one of the eight that we need to install. So we'll just do the same thing all the way through the engine and get all the springs installed here with the keepers.